Hi, welcome back to Movie Review Mom. Today, the movie I'm reviewing is called Out of Liberty. This movie is rated PG. It's 111 minutes long. You do the math. How long is that? And the Movie Review Mom grade that I gave it is a B. It's a solid movie. And it actually begins in 1838, right after Joseph Smith and some other religious leaders surrender to the Missouri militia under threat of Mormon extermination and end up in Liberty Jail. Very ironic name, I might add, for a prison with horrible conditions. Joseph Smith and several other leaders in the church were held captive there for 155 days, while members of the church outside the prison walls were terrorized by mobs. The film is based on actual recorded accounts and obviously is a true story. Those who are not members of The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints will most likely be unfamiliar with this part of church history and the people involved in the telling of it. It's not the preachy Christian movie you might be expecting, but kind of feels more like a Western with some heart. And it's very different and unique in the Mormon genre for members of The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Some quick tips for parents, and that is, kids might be a little bit bored. So might some adults. That's not to say the movie isn't good, because it is, but it's one of those talking movies. There are some action, a little bit of scuffle and some guns and shooting and that kind of stuff, but it's not like a huge Western with lots of action. So I'm just trying to give you the heads up so you can manage your expectations. There's some talk of mobs and killing people, although you don't see anybody actually get shot and die or anything like that. Some positive themes are blinded by hate and what that can do to our perspective, justice, obeying the law versus following your heart perspective. And then there's a line that I think is really interesting by Judge Turnham, played by Sean Stevens. And he says, the loudest voice is that of public opinion. So again, all along the theme of justice versus public opinion is really fascinating and done very well, I think. So some things that I really liked are, first of all, the movie starts off with some beautiful artistic details with camera work by Jeremy Prusso and good direction by Garrett Batty. Again, especially the very beginning of the movie, I didn't notice it so much towards the middle and end, probably because I was getting more involved with the story, but I was really impressed at the very beginning with it, and it was noticeable to me. By far, the standout is Jason Wade. He is fantastic and pretty much can do no wrong in movies. I love him in every movie I've ever seen him in, and I always think he's the best actor in every movie that I've seen him in. You might have seen him in movies like 17 Miracles, Saints and Soldiers, Airborne, Creed, and the Cokeville Miracle, although he's been in many more. I just think that he does a fantastic job, and he plays Samuel Tiller, who's the jailer at Liberty Jail, and I just, again, I'm such a fan of his. I also appreciated Corbin Allred's accurate portrayal of Porter Rockwell's high-pitched voice. Most people will recognize him from the roles in movies such as The Saratov Approach and Saints and Sinners, Airborne, Creed, but did you know he actually was also in the movie Robin Hood, Men in Tights? He's delightful, and he shows this fierce loyalty that Porter Rockwell really did have as one of the guards for Joseph Smith. And so he does a great job, and I really enjoyed his performance as well. The scene when the wives were visiting their husbands in Liberty Jail was very touching and even got me a little teary-eyed. And while their reunion was very tender, that alone could get you teary-eyed, it was really the facial expressions on Jason Wade's face that just really got me. And again, I just think he's fantastic. I recently heard Carrie Wrigley speak and sing at BYU Education Week, so it was fun to see her in this movie, even though she just has a very small role in it. The music is absolutely lovely, scored by Robert Allen Elliott. And again, it was noticeably good, so much so that I had to look up who did the score for the movie because I liked it so much. I always love it when information is shared with the audience at the end of the movie to explain what happened next to the real people portrayed in the film. And so this movie has that at the very end, although I wish that there had been more information included and offered at the end. The cast includes Larry Bagby, Adam Johnson, Corbin Allred, I mentioned, Brandon Ray Olive, Sean Stevens, Brock Roberts, Cyrus Daniels, Eric Wood, Morgan Gunter, Carrie Wrigley, I mentioned, and of course the fantastic Jason Wade. I noticed that a Kickstarter fund was actually used to get the movie starting, and I just started, and I just think that that's so great that so many good things can come when everybody pitches in to help. If you're a fan of Gentry, the Gentleman Trio, by the way, you'll love seeing Casey Elliott in the movie playing Hiram Smith. So that was a fun surprise. Sidney Rigdon is a man in church history, and he's basically portrayed as a self-serving coward. And some may say that he really was in real life. In fact, many of these men that were held captive in Liberty Jail are not represented in the best light, unlike most, opposite of what you see in LDS movies where, you know, they're good guys. And of course they were good guys, but here in Liberty Jail, they're personalities are captured in their lowest moments as they really struggle with their faith and with what's happening to them, and especially because they're innocent, and to their families and to all of the members of the church at the time. And I think that's exactly what makes this movie powerful, different, and insightful, is because it's not like this typical preachy feel good, you know, try to convert you and make you want to learn more about the church. You see these men who are very real with very real frailties and weaknesses. And hopefully that will pique your curiosity and you'll want to learn a little bit more about this part of church history. Now, there were a few things that I didn't like. First of all, Brandon Ray Olive did a fine job as Joseph Smith. He really did. So I don't have any complaints with his performance. I think my only complaint is simply that he looks less like the prophet Joseph Smith than I've ever seen in any other movie about him. And now, of course, I realize that actors don't always have to look like the people that they're portraying, but I always appreciate it when a director tries to make an effort to match talent with appearance. Brandon is not a member of the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, but I'm told he was very careful to portray Joseph with respect and kindness because he knows how beloved this particular man and prophet Joseph Smith was. You might have seen Brandon before in movies like Logan Lucky, NCIS, CSI, or even HBO's Mosaic. Some moviegoers will hope for lots of action, I mentioned, and be a little disappointed that there isn't that much, that it's more of one of those talking movies like I mentioned before. There's a lot of disgusting and humorous talk and display of feces and bodily functions and all of that. Kids will probably get a kick out of that. And then some of the acting is really not that great. And there are some really interesting lines in the movie. For example, Brandon Ray Olive, who plays Joseph Smith, says, "We all leave here changed men." And that's really true. And you watch that change take place slowly as they're really grappling with what's happening to them and their situation. And it's really a fascinating character study. Jason Wade, who plays the Samuel Tiller, the jailer, says, "It's no longer my job, it's my duty." And again, that theme of duty versus right versus wrong, justice versus the public opinion, all of that interplays and is done really well and unfolds really nicely, I think. And that also the jailer says, "It's better that 10 guilty escape than one innocent suffer," as he himself is also watching everything that's unfolding. And his job is to defend this prison, whether he believes the people inside are guilty or innocent. And so it's really fascinating to watch him try to understand what's right and what's wrong in this particular case. All right, well, that's it for my movie review. I hope that you enjoyed it. If you do, please leave your comments down below. Visit my website, which is called moviereviewmom.com, where you can read a little bit more about it. And I'll see you next time. Bye for now.